Hi students, coming to our next topic, that is asset properties. So in the previous video we had seen that what is a transaction management and what are the transaction means. So let us see here the asset properties. So first thing is, in order to maintain database, in order to maintain consistency in database, before or after transaction, certain properties are followed by the transaction. So if you want to maintain the database in consistency state, means to in a correct state, so before or after transactions, these transactions has to follow some certain properties. So those properties you call it as asset properties. Okay, so the main use of this asset property is to ensure, in order to ensure accuracy, completeness, and data integrity, we will use this asset property. Okay, so here A means atomicity, C means consistency, I is isolation, and D means durability. So these are all the different properties that are used while you are doing the transactions. So if the transaction is satisfies all these properties, then you can say that the database, whatever the database you are having, that database is in consistent state. It is following the correct procedure, it is having the accurate correct values. So atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. So let us discuss one by one. So first is atomicity. So what is atomicity? So it states that the transaction must be an atomic. The first point is the atomicity is nothing but it states that the transaction, whatever you are doing, that must be atomic. Transaction must be atomic. So what it means? Atomic means either all of its operations are executed or none operations. Means all transactions should be completed. Or none. So nothing has to be done, means you have your database is unchanged. So atomicity means it must be atomic. Atomic means it has to do all the operations or it doesn't do anything. Okay, so you call this atomicity is also called as all or nothing rule. So we call it as all or nothing rule. Okay, so here if one part of transaction fails, entire transaction is also fail in the database. Means if suppose it's doing some operation, suddenly some failure is occur in your database. So what it does, it will makes the transactions unchanged. So whatever the before your database is in consistent state, it will be also in that consistent state itself. Okay, means it's all or nothing rule. It does if all the transaction has to be completed or nothing will be completed. So here we are, it involves two operations. In atomicity involves two operations, abort or commit. Abort or commit. Abort means changes made to database are not visible. So whenever you are keep the transaction as abort. Whenever you say that transaction is abort, means the changes whatever made to a database are not visible, means they are not saved. Commit means changes made to database are visible. So means after the completion only we are use the commit statement. Whenever you make the statement transaction as a commit, then the whatever the changes that are made in the database are visible to you. Okay, so let us take one example for explaining this atomicity. Example, right? T1 and T2 are two transactions. Let us take these are two transactions. Okay, so if you want to transfer amount, suppose amount 100 rupees from account A to account B. Okay, so two transactions are there. You want to transfer 100 rupees from account A to account B. So already in account A you are having 500 rupees and in account B you are having 200 rupees. So 500 rupees and 200 rupees are there. So this is a T1 transaction. First what it does, it read A value. So 500 is read first. So after that A minus 100 means the 100 amounts you have to be transferred. So deduct 100 rupees from A account. Then you have to save it, write A. So T2 transaction, read B. So whatever the is there, the B consisting of 200 rupees. So it reads 2 and the B is equal to B plus 100. Means we are transferring A to B. So A 100 should be minus and B 100 should be added. Right? B. So now value of A is, here it is 400 and here it is 200 plus 100, 300. So here you have to check before transaction A and B will be is 700 and after transaction A and B is 400 plus 300 is equal to 700. So then we can say that the database in consistent state. So after doing the transactions also the database is maintaining the consistent state. Okay, so this actually the exact process. Suppose some failure is occurred. So if you are not using the atomicity property or if you are not using the consistency properties, so if suddenly if you are transferring the amount from A to B, so before, if transaction fails after T1 before T2, so it doesn't execute this, only it just transfer the 100 rupees and suddenly the system fails or the power failure is occur. What it is, the amount in A is deducted but is not added in B. So the result will be in inconsistent state. So the result is, it is in inconsistent state. Okay. So here if you are not using the atomicity property, if the transaction fails doing before after T2 before T means after the completion of T1 before T2, okay, if the suddenly the transaction system fails, the amount in account A is deducted but it is not added in the B, so it will cause the inconsistent state. Okay, so to overcome this problem we are using the atomicity. So what this atomicity will do, okay, so if the suddenly the system fails, it keeps whatever the changes that are made in the system will be unchanged. That means aborted, the transaction is aborted. So changes made to database are not visible until the transaction is completed. Okay, so after transaction is completed, if you use the commit statement, then only the changes made to the system are visible. So this atomicity will help the transaction to maintain the database in a consistent state. So whenever the system fails before in the middle of the transactions, the system doesn't make those changes as a permanent until you commit the system. Okay, so that you call it as atomicity.